Okay, welcome. I'm so excited to have you here today. This is the first day we start bilingual service. Are you excited? No, I don't know. No, okay. We are on the series of Living as a Kingdom Citizen series. 지금 뭐 배우고 있죠, 우리? Kingdom. 하나님의 백성으로 어떻게 살아가는가? Living on today, living your life based on God's grace. 하나님의 은혜로 사는 게 뭔가? 시리즈에서 우리가 Don't live by faith, by sight. Don't live by sight, by faith. 뭐라 보는 대로 살지 말고 안 쓰는 표현인데 Don't live by sight but faith 믿음으로 살아라 오늘 Today's title is Make a Faith Decision What is today's title? Make a Faith Decision In Korean is 믿음의 결단으로 인생을 역전시키라는 제목으로 하나님 말씀 증거합니다 Today's passage Bible reference today inspired by God for us to preach to the world is Hebrews 11:30 and 31 Hebrews 11:30-31 Hebrews 11. Let's read it together. 믿음으로 7일 동안 여리고를 더니 성이 무너졌으며 믿음으로 기생나압은 정탐꾼을 평안히 영접하였으므로 순종하지 아니하는 자와 함께 멸망하지 아니하였도다. 왜 발음이 한국말 발음 깨지고 있네? By faith Rahab the harlot did not perish along with those who are disobedient. After she had welcomed the spies in peace. You know the story of Rahab the harlot. Hebrews 11 is a really famous chapter, right? Hebrews 11, it's called the Hall of Faith. You know, Hall of Fame, 믿음의 전당, okay? In chapter in Hebrews 11, you see a lot of wonderful figures, the superheroes of faith. This is the Old Testament figures, okay? 모두 다 뭐예요? 구약의 사람들입니다. Old Testament figures, right? And present to the New Testament believers. Old Testament figures present to the New Testament believers so that we can emulate 닮아가는 거예요. Right? 닮아가고 배워가기 위해서 하나님이 우리에게 주신 사람들입니다. They are Old Testament figures, but they are presented to New Testament church so that you will live by faith. These things will happen, okay? And then there are superheroes of faith. Somebody like Noah, right? By faith, Noah built an ark. Superhero. Abraham, who had become the father of faith. Superhero. Moses, who cut the Red Sea in half, superhero, confronting the superpower of his time, Pharaoh, right? So Moses confronted Pharaoh and turned the river of Nile into blood. 엄청난 사람들 얘기가 나옵니다, right? 히브리서 11장에 가면 엄청난 사람들 얘기. 나일강을 그냥 피로, 피계, 이파, 악독, 우매, 흑장, 열 가지 재앙을 일으키고, 당시에 최고의 슈퍼파워였던 바로에게 하나님 말씀을 전했던 놀라운 사람 모세 같은 사람의 얘기가 나옵니다. But in Hebrews 11, we have quite strange figure. This is Hall of Faith, right? Chapter 11, Hall of Faith. A lot of superheroes of faith are there. Somebody like really far away from us. 우리랑은 좀 관련이 없는 사람들 같은. 우리가 목욕탕을 가면 목욕탕이 반으로 갈라지지 않죠? 우리랑 관련이 없는 사람 같은 사람인데 여기에 좀 이상한 사람이 하나 나옵니다. Unlike candidate. There's an unlike candidate to be in the Hall of Faith. Her name is Rahab. Not only a girl, but her job is prostitute. 창녀라합이. 창녀가 하나님의 11장의 superhero of faith 안에 들어가는 역사가 있다는 There's an unlikely candidate who seems to be disqualified to be in the Hall of Faith. First, her identity as a person is listed here. First, she was a woman. Okay? In a New Testament time, when the Bible was written, women are not considered as equal to men. Women as considered as belongings to men. 여자는 그렇게 고대 시대 때 유명한 사람이 아니었습니다. Social status. Her social status woman, female figure, okay? She is totally seems to be disqualified. I think Hebrew서를 읽는 사람들은 발음이 영어나 한국말이니까 히브리서를 읽는 사람들. 히브리서를 읽는 사람들은 독자들이 충격을 받았을 거예요. 나 Rahab the harlot in the Hall of Fame like equal to Abraham, equal to Moses, equal to Noah, who built the ark. Her social figure, I think disqualified. What about second one? She was a Gentile. She came from the world of pagan worship. 믿는 사람이 아니었어요. 이방인이었습니다. 이방인인 Harlot, 이방인인 여자가 믿음의 전당에 이름을 등록합니다. 너희들은 이 사람을 닮아라. The worst of all, 가장 심각한 문제가 뭡니까? Her occupational status, okay? Her job was a prostitute. She was a harlot. She was a prostitute. 창녀가 믿음의 전당에 이름을 기억합니다. This is like unlikely, right? This is pretty shocking. She's an unlikely candidate to be in the Hall of Faith. She seems to be disqualified, not qualified. And Joshua chapter 2 unfolds the reason why her name is listed in the book of faith, the Hall of Faith. Let's go to Joshua chapter 2. The reason why she is in the Hall of Faith is specifically unfolded in the book of Joshua. Unfolded, right? Let's read it in Korean. 눈의 아들 여호사가 시팀에서 두 사람의 정탐꾼을 보내어 to send soup to spies. Two spies snuck into the promised land in order to conquer the land. Okay, God called them to conquer the land. This is the promised land we're talking about, right? Why did you stay so many years in the wilderness to go to the promised land? This is the ultimate destination they got to go into. And now there, and then Joshua was so excited and sent two spies into Jericho, invincible city. 무적 제리코에게 two spies를 보냈어요. Go and collect some intel. 정보를 좀 캐와라. High intel. This is intel war. Okay? CIA. 국정원. Okay? Spies. They are sent by Joshua to go into the promised land and sneak into the city of Jericho to collect some information, collect some intel. 그들이 가서 라합이라는 기생의 집에 들어가 거기에 유숙하니. Her house was built into the wall and then it was built into the wall and it was located at the gate area. So everybody passing and coming through and they gotta go in there and they stay in the prostitute's house. They walk through the red light street. It's called red light street. 어떤 사람이 여리고 왕에게 말하되 There's a guy, okay? Some guy spotted two spies coming in. Okay? This is North Korea, and then two South Korean spies, okay, walking into the city of Pyongyang, okay? And a guy spotted the two South Korean spies because they talk in a Korean dialect, maybe. 전라도 dialect, right? 음에 이것이 평양이요, right? And then everybody like, can easily notice that. And 어떤 사람이 여리고 왕에게 말해, they directly, you know, call the guy 113, 간첩이 왔어요. 이 밤에 이스라엘 자손 몇 사람이 이 땅을 점탐하러 이리로 들어왔나이다. Of course, right? This is the response of the king of Jericho. 여리고 왕이 라합에게 사람을 보내요. King, center, 국정원 용원들, right? 안기부 people, CIA agents. And he sent the king of Jericho, not the director of CIA. Okay, this is really direct order from the president of the Jericho. The president of Jericho sent the whole army, maybe. Okay? 국정원 용원들, 안기부 용원들, right? To the Rahab's house. 이르되 내게로 와서 내 집에 들어간 사람들을 끌어내라. Turn the spies in to us. 그들을 끌어내라. Pull them out of your house. 그들이 이 땅을 정탐하러 왔느니라. Verse 4. 그 여인이 두 사람에 Rahab said, Rahab already hidden them. Rahab already hid them, maybe in the upper room. 다락에다 숨겼어요. 과연 그 사람들이 내게 왔었으나 They came. Right, you're right. They came to this house. 그들이 어디서 왔는지 나는 알지 못해. I don't know where they are coming from. I didn't know that they are sent by Joshua. But 그 사람들이 어두워 성문을 닫을 때쯤 되어 나갔으니 어디로 갔는지 내가 알지 못하나 급히 따라가라 그러면 그들을 따라잡으리라. I don't know where they're coming from, but they just left this house. Go after them, you know, follow them. Probably they went to that direction, okay? Follow them. Catch them up.
What? That's a lie.
Okay? A lady listed, whose name is listed in the Hall of Faith, lie. Is it okay to lie then? We come to a very significant question that we got to raise. Is it okay to tell a lie? Is it okay to tell a lie? No. Lying is sin. Then is it okay to tell a lie here? When it is okay. When is it okay for us to tell a lie then? First of all, it's not okay to lie. Lying is sin. Then what is this occasion is all about? This is very unique situation where there is no choice for you to make but to lie. Okay? This is not a lie or a sin or not to sin issue. This is the two sins issue. One sin is telling a lie, and the other sin is turning in God's messenger to be killed. You gotta sin this, you gotta sin one, this one particular sin or the other type of sin. Telling a lie or turning God's messengers into the king of Jericho so that they could be killed. There's no choice but to lie, okay? In a situation, when you're stuck in a situation, you gotta tell a lie, okay? In other words, you gotta do the right thing the right way, right? You shouldn't do the right thing the wrong way. You gotta do always right thing in the right way. But when you cannot do the right way, you gotta do the right thing. 내가 옳은 방법으로 옳은 일을 하는 게 제일 좋죠? 옳은 방법으로, 정당한 방법으로, 올바른 방법으로 옳은 일을 해야 합니다. 그러나 어떨 때는 옳은 일을 해야 될 때가 있다는 거예요. 방법이 그렇게 할 수 없지만 할 수 없이 방법이 옳을 수밖에 없는 경우가 너무나 많이 있다는 겁니다. 여러분 옳게 일을 해야 될 때는 반드시 옳게 일을 해야 됩니다. 그러나 항상 우리는 We gotta do right thing. 그리스도인은 살면서 해야 되는 일이 뭐냐? 우리는 항상 옳은 일을 해야 되는 거예요. So she chose to tell a lie. Well, which is bigger sin? Telling a lie or turning God's messengers in to be killed? So she chose the lesser sin. Okay? So when you can't do the right thing the right way, you gotta do the right thing. You know what I'm saying, right? You can't do the right thing the right way. If the right way is not given, and there's only one option, the only one option would be you do the right thing. When you can't do right things the right way, then choose to do the right thing to glorify God. That's what Rahab did. Rahab continued to choose the right thing, do the right thing. Whenever you have two sins and those are the only options you have, then you must make the decision that God's name would be honored the most. You can glorify God. But when you have a choice to do the right thing, right way, you got to do the right thing, right way. But you should not use this tactic when you have an option to tell the truth, okay? This is not justifiable all the time. This is very unique situation. It's like sending the Bible to North Korea is illegal, right? But you got to send the Bible to North Korea because that's the only one option you got. Then you got to send the Bible to the North Korea. You got to teach the Bible. You got to spread the gospel in North Korea, right? Because spreading the gospel in North Korea is illegal. You cannot do the right way, but you got to do the right thing. That's what Christians should do. Rahab the harlot made a decision. She chose to do the right thing. 9절입니다. 말하되 여호와께서 이 땅을 너희에게 주신 줄을 내가 아노라. 우리가 너희를 심히 두려워하고 이 땅의 주민들이 다 너희 앞에서 간담이 녹나니. We heard the story of what God did in Egypt. We heard the story of what God did on the wilderness, and our hearts melt away. We are scared. Okay? 우리가 복음을 들었어요. 하나님이 어떤 일을 하는지를 들었습니다. 하나님이 이집트에서 어떤 일을 하셨고 피게 이빨 악도금에 흑장을 하신 걸 들었습니다. 그리고 간담이 녹았습니다. 이는 너희가 애굽에서 나올 때에 여호와께서 너희 앞에 홍해의 물을 마르게 하신 일과 너희가 요단 저쪽에 있는 아모리 사람 두 왕 시온과 옥에게 행하늘 The king of Oak and king of Sion. Okay, what God did to the king of Og and king of Sion was heard. They heard the gospel. They heard how beautiful, how wonderful God is. They heard the God's identity. They heard the magnificence of God.
곧 그들을 전멸시킨 일을 우리가 들었느니 하나님을 대항했던 모든 사람들이 완전히 전멸됐음을 들었습니다.
They heard the message. 11. 우리가 듣자. Okay? 우리. Everybody here heard the message. 마음이 녹았고 our hearts melt away.
너희로 말미암아 사람이 정신을 잃었느니라.
We all fainted. The message was pretty shocking. There's a wonderful God, and God brought people, His people out of Egypt, and they are on the way, marching on to us. What should we do?
That was a choice that they got to make.
여호와는 위로서, 위로는 하늘에서도, 아래는 땅에서도 하나님이시니라. 나일강도 뒤집고, 땅도 뒤집고, 마른 땅도 뒤집고, 모든 것, 천지의 모든 것을 뒤집은 하나님의 이름을 들었습니다. Same message, but different responses. They heard the same message, right? But King of Jericho and the people in the Jericho, they decided to go against God.
똑같은 메시지를 들었으나 그들은 하나님을 대항하기로 결정했습니다. 왜 그들은 하나님을 대항하기로 결정했습니까? 그들은 이집트보다 자기들이 더 강했다고 생각하기 때문에.
But Rahab made a faith decision. I'm going to align myself with God.
나는 하나님을 선택하는 결정을 하겠습니다.
The same message but different responses. We heard the message about what God had done to the king of Egypt, the king of Og, and kings of nations on the way to here. But I am gonna make a faith decision to align myself with God. But these people do not make that decision. They decided, the king of Jericho decided to go against God, but I'm gonna make a faith decision to against the decision that king of Og make, king of Jericho make. I'm gonna make a faith decision to choose God over the popularity. Choose God over the notoriety. Choose God over the money. Choose God over my life. Choose God over everything that I gotta cost.
내 목숨이 부서진다 할지라도, 내 명예가 무너진다 할지라도, 나는 하나님을 선택하겠다.
She made a faith decision. But everybody else is making a different decision.
모든 사람들이 하나님을 선택하지 않을 때, 라합은 하나님을 선택했습니다.
Rahab became so alone. Being committed to Christ sometimes means you find yourself by yourself. There's nobody. Everybody else is going this direction, but you are going this direction. Everybody is not praying, but you're praying. Everybody is not reading the Bible, you're reading the Bible. Everybody is taking a rest on Sunday morning, but you come here and you listen to the Word of God. Why? Because you know that God is the God deserves the highest worship.
모두가 하나님을 선택하지 않을 때 그녀는 하나님을 선택했습니다. That's a faith decision.
She became alone. She finds herself by herself. Even after the message, the citizens of Jericho decided to go against God. But Rahab the harlot made a faith decision to go against the culture. She made a decision to go against the culture when the culture that she lived in decided to go against God. I want you not to follow the culture. We're not called to follow the culture. We're not called to be conformed to the pattern of this world. We are called to follow God. Sometimes being committed to Christ requires that you find yourself by yourself. You're lonely. Okay? You made that decision, you know me, because you're alone is the person who made a decision. But God's going to pay for that. God's going to pay for that. When everybody else is going down with the decision they made, you're going to survive alone. You alone are there to make that precious decision of faith, and you may feel that, man, I'm alone. But enjoy that, because you alone will enjoy the blessing. When Rahab the harlot decided to go against the culture, let's see what happened. At that moment, Rahab the prostitute turned into Rahab the bride of Christ, who decided to die with Christ for his glory,
her identity transformed.
그녀의 인생은 창녀였습니다. 그러나 이 결정을 통하여 그녀는 더 이상 창녀가 아닌 창대하게 사람이 되었습니다. 창녀에서 창대한 인생. By faith decision, you know, we all believe in Christ. Okay? We all believe that we're gonna go to heaven. We all know that one day we're gonna go to heaven, but my life right now is like that of Rahab.
창녀 같은 인생을 사는 거예요. 인생 자체가 내가 예수를 믿고 있지만, 내가 예수를 따르고 있지만, 오늘 나의 인생이 stuck in dirt, depressed. My life, there's nothing good in my life. It's like a dead of Rahab. Where should I go? You're lost. You don't know what to do. Depression, sadness, surrounded by evil people all the time. But you make a decision now. You're going to make a faith. This is like a Rahab dead. Your life will start from day on. Her life from 창녀 to 창대. By making that decision. Let's look at what she did after she aligned herself with God over the culture. First, she made a faith decision, and she did what? Second one, 12. 그러므로 이제 청하노니, 내가 너희를 선대하였은 즉. She's talking to the spies. 너희도 내 아버지의 집을 선대하도록 여호와로 맹세하고 내게 징표를 보이라. 선대 here means hesed. Show kindness. I hesed to you. You hesed to me. That's what she said. I make a face decision. I hesed to you. Actually, you know, spies, they got a hesed to her, but she's hesed to them.
그리고 나의 부모와 나의 남녀 형제와 그들에게 속한 모든 사람들을 살려주고 우리 목숨을 죽음에서 건져내라. 그 사람들이 그에게 이르되 내가 우리의 이 일을 누설하지 아니하면 우리 목숨으로 너희를 대신할 것이요. They make a deal. This is covenant relationship. This is church. My life for your life. Okay? I die for you in preaching. I'm sick, but I came here. I die my life, okay? I lay down my life for you. So that your life will be laid down for me. As one body, we all lay down our lives for Christ. This is the church. Covenant relationship. 언약 관계 있습니다. 우리는 서로를 욕하지 않습니다. 우리는 서로를 사랑합니다. 서로의 나쁜 점을 보지 않습니다. 교회! 언약 관계를 맺어집니다. Rahab the prostitute! Rahab the bride of Christ. Isn't that wonderful? No matter what kind of life you're going through now, no matter what you did last week, no matter what happened last week, or no matter what happened last year, it doesn't matter. If you make that faith decision right now, your life will be changed. Transform into new life. This is a new beginning that you can start your life. 라합이 그들을 창문에 줄을 라푼젤, okay? 라합이 그들을 창문에서 줄을 내려다니 그의 집이 성벽 위에 있으므로 그가 성벽 위에 거주하였습니다. Her house was built into the wall, okay? 라합이 그들이 이르되 두렵건대 뒤쫓는 사람들이 너희와 마주칠까 하노니 너희는 산으로 가서 거기에 사흘 동안 숨어 있다가 She also giving the directions. Follow my directions, so you know that I know the geographical, you know, locations here. Just go there and then hide there for several days and go there. You know, because they are following. Ungive people, right? They are chasing after them, and she tells every single intel. She reveals the intel.
사흘 동안 숨어 있다가 뒤쫓는 자들이 돌아간 후에 너희의 길을 갈지어다. 사흘 동안 숨어 있다가, 사흘 동안 죽어 있다가 그들은 다시 살아납니다.
그 사람들이 그에게 이르되 내가 우리에게 서약한 이 맹세. 여러분, 교회로 올 때 우리는 맹세를 합니다. 나는 너를 욕하지 않을 것이다. 나는 너를 사랑할 것이다. 의리예요. 교회는 서로 우리 모두는 죄사함을 받았습니다. 그럼 우리는 서로의 죄를 보지 않습니다. 이 맹세대 우리가 허물이 없게 하리라. 우리가 이 땅에 들어올 때에 우리가 달아내린 창문에 이 붉은 줄을 메고 and there's a sign, okay? 붉은 줄.
This signifies the blood of Jesus Christ. 3 days later, Jesus will be resurrected.
After she made a death decision and then she cut a deal. Okay? She made a decision first and then she cut a deal. I'm going to save you. I'm going to risk my life. And then, please, I show your kindness first, right? And show, you show me kindness later. She made a faith decision first and then made a cut a deal. You know, this is so different from most of us. We try to cut a deal and then make a faith decision. God, if you give me $5,000 first, then I'm going to believe in you. That's a backward Christian song. Okay? This is quite contrary to most of us do. We first cut a deal. Show me something. Then I'm going to believe in you. That's not living by faith. Show me something. You see something, right? And then you believe in God. That's not living by faith. That's living by sight. 하나님 나에게 먼저 보여주세요. 그럼 내가 따라가겠습니다. 그거는 믿음을 따라가는 겁니까? 내가 사이트를 따라가는 겁니까? No wonder why we do not experience so many miracles that God is... No wonder why we do not experience God. We try to cut a deal first, then make a decision. 하나님을 따라가는 게 먼저고, 보는 건 나중이에요. 따라합시다. 선 따라감, 후 증거. 따라가는 게 먼저고, 보는 게 나중입니다. 근데 우리는 뭐라고 돼요? 보여주세요, 따라갈게요. 보여주세요, 따라갈게요. 돈을 주세요, 그럼 헌금할게요. 하나님 역사하세요, 그럼 내가 믿어줄게요. 그러면 그건 living by sight, not living by faith. Only living by faith. You know, faith is really important. Don't say, give me money, then I will do this. Don't say, give me a job, then I will represent you at work. Don't say, give me this and give me that, I will do this and do that, okay? That's living by sight. That's contrary to living by faith. 보여줘서 따라가는 게 아니라 따라가니 보이는 겁니다. 할렐루야. Amen? I want your response, okay? I mean, clap your hands, wow, you know, do something like that. You clap. Do something first. This is not walking by faith, this is walking by sight. Walking by sight, you will not be able to see God working in your life. This is stupidity. This is dumb. Okay? You always walk by sight. Wow, this is good. You know, this is good. Walk by sight. You worship the circumstances. That's idol worship. We don't live by sight. We live by faith in Christ. Your hearts are not melted away because of circumstances. You don't see things and be touched. You read the Bible and believe in it and touch it. That's walking by faith. Why? Why is that so important? Let's look at Ephesians 2:8. By grace, we have been saved, right? Through what? Through faith. There's a grace. An abundant amount of grace is just displayed among, you know, in front of us. What is required? When you have faith, when you make a decision, faith decision, the grace of God becomes real to you. By grace, it's all by grace. God's going to work through your life, okay? God's going to work in your life, but through faith. Faith is so important. When you make a faith decision, the grace that you heard from the Bible study, the grace related stories that you heard through the sermons, through the Bible studies. Oh, those grace related stories become yours when you make a faith decision. So you got to live by faith, not by sight. 교회 와서 기도하고, 교회 와서 말씀 보고, 교회 와서 예배 드리는 것으로 우리 인생이 변하는 게 아닙니다. 내가 들었던 말씀, 내가 배웠던 말씀이 우리 인생에서 삶이 돼야 되는 거예요. 들은 것이 중요하고 기도하는 게 중요한 게 아니라 우리 안에서 들었던 말씀에 순종하는 마음으로 믿음의 결단을 내릴 때 하나님의 은혜가 내가 들었던 하나님의 은혜가 내가 들었던 하나님, 내가 배웠던 하나님의 은혜가 비로소 나의 삶의 일부가 될 수 있다는 거예요. 듣기만 하는 거예요. 마치 문법만 배우는 학생처럼. 회화는 아무것도 못해. 문법만 잘해서 그 문법을 잘하는 것이 오히려 수치가 될 수 있다는 거예요. 하나님은 무엇으로 역사하십니까? 하나님 우리의 믿음을 통해 역사하십니다. 중요한 건 기도를 몇 시간 했느냐가 아닙니다. 중요한 건 내가 기도했던 말씀을 내가 순종하고 있느냐가 중요한 거예요. Do you want to see God working in your life? Then make a faith decision today. What kind of decision you gotta make? Think about it. Pray about it. Read the Bible about it. And then do it. Make a faith decision today like Rahab did. Don't wait for the signs. Okay? Don't wait for the signs. God, show me the signs that I'm going to follow you. Don't do that. Don't play that game. Don't play that game because God's not going to follow that direction of yours. God's not going to be in a trap for that. That's a trap. He's going to fall into that trap. He's not going to give you signs. And he's going to continue to encourage you to follow, to make a decision. That's not walking, because that's a walking by sight. Make a faith decision first. You're required to go to the Red Sea of yours before you see the God cutting half. What you gotta do? If you wanna see God cutting the Red Sea half, okay? If you wanna see God working in your life, cutting the Red Sea of yours half, what do you have to do? You gotta go to the Red Sea. 나의 인생이 홍해가 갈라지길 원하지만 나의 인생이 홍해를 가지 않는 자는 홍해가 갈라지는 걸 볼 수가 없다는 거예요. You're required to go to the Jordan River of yours before you see God opening up. 요단강을 건너기를 원하면서 요단강에 가지 않습니다. 하나님, 요단강에 나를 데리고 가주세요. 순종이 아닙니다. 내가 주인인 거예요. 하나님, 나를 하게 만들어 주시옵소서. 하십시오.
If you believe, you gotta do it.
Offer your bodies as a living sacrifice. Holy and pleasing to God. Offer your body as a living sacrifice. You know, genuine worship, true worship is that you offer your bodies as a living sacrifice. Do something first. Okay? Make a faith decision. This is a spiritual worship.
Let's see what happened to Rahab as a consequence of making this faith decision. We gotta follow, right? We gotta hear the story. What happened because of the faith decision that she made?
First of all, what she said in faith becomes real in life, okay? She prayed this and prayed that, okay? People are coming to church and then in the testimony time, right? They just talk. You know, like doctrines, right? You know, doctrines of justification, doctrines of sanctification, doctrines of glorification, but their lives are so messed up. I've seen so many people, even the preachers, even the like theological students. There are so many theological students coming to church and they are so fluent, okay, eloquent in presenting the gospel, but their life is so far away from the gospel. What she said in faith became real in her life, okay? What you say every day, I want to do this, I want to do that, I want to do this, I want to do that, but like nothing happens. You only say, I want to do this, I want to do that, I want to do this, do that, I want to do that, all the time. And nothing happens. What she says, I want to do this and that, that thing was actualized in her life. What she said in faith, what she said in a prayer time, what she said in a testimony time, what she said in the cell group time, okay? It became real in her life. She said to Spies, verse 12, now then, please swear to me by the Lord that you will show kindness. I already told you that the kindness here is what? Hesed. Hesed means God's covenantal covering love. Okay? Which means that she's saying that what? God, cover me with your grace. Okay? God, cover me with your grace. Which means excluded. Let my life be excluded. 하나님이 나를 덮으시면 나만 덮으시는 거죠. 나만 덮어지면 그 저변 이전에 있는 것들 덮어지면 베타적 축복권을 갖는 거예요. 이 베타적 축복권을 갖기를 그녀는 원했습니다. 하나님 나를 덮어주십시오. I show hesed to you, you show hesed to me. God show hesed to me. When the city of Jericho collapsed, everything else was destroyed but her house. God covered her house alone. 여리고 성이 무너졌을 때 그녀가 매일 입으로 말했던 것처럼 하나님 나의 인생을 커버해 주시 했던 것처럼 모든 집은 다 무너졌으나 그녀의 집만 살아남았습니다. God covered
her house.
When she made a decision, what she said in a cell group time, what she said in a prayer time became real in her life.
저는 여러분의 인생에 여러분이 입으로 하는 모든 말들이 땅에 떨어지지 않기를 축원합니다. 여러분, 신자의 권위가 어디서 옵니까? 신자의 권위는 말에서 옵니다. 이웃들에게 말하는 거예요. 하나님이 난 반드시 날 축복하시겠다. 근데 맨날 저주가 일어나. 뭐가 잘못된 거죠. 내가 말하는 것이 곧 나 인생에 일어나는 것이 되어야 합니다. 어떻게 그것이 가능해졌냐? 그녀가 fake decision을 했기 때문이라는 거예요. 이해되십니까? Make a fake decision in your life.
They marched around the Jericho seven times on Saturday. They blow the trumpets and the walls start collapsing except one piece of wall. The one piece of wall where her house was built into. That place was covered by the grace of God. The supernatural power comes upon the word she spoke to people. Because she made a faith decision. Don't tell me that you're going to say, oh, you, don't tell me all the time, I want to go to the Red Sea. I want to go to the Red Sea. Don't tell me, I want to go to the Red Sea. I want to go, I want to see God working in my life, cutting the Red Sea of my health. Don't talk about it all the time. Go to the Red Sea to see God working for you. To see God working miraculously, cutting the Red Sea in half. Obedience is required. She got a miracle covering by God.
Second thing, all things work for the good in her life. This is amazing. What is her job?
Rahab the harlot.
모든 일이 협력하여 선을 이루었습니다. 그녀의 믿음의 결정으로 인하여 모든 일이 협력, 모든 일이.
What was, you know, just guess with me, okay? What was the thing that she wanted to cover? Just guess.
그녀가 감추고 싶었던 게 뭐였을 것 같아요? 여자로서 그녀가 감추고 싶은 게 뭐였을 것 같습니까? 내가 감추고 싶은 그것, 내가 사람들이 알지 않기를 원하는 그것이 뭐였을 거예요? 그녀의 직업이었을 거예요.
Ray of the harbor. But you know what? That wasn't made possible because God publicized this. Billions of Bible readers now know what kind of job she had.
성경을 읽는 모든 사람들은 이제 압니다. Rahab the harlot. 라합이 창녀인 것을 모두가 알게 된 거예요. 성경을 읽는 모든 사람, 당시의 모든 사람들, 이스라엘에 있는 모든 사람들은 라합의 직업이 무엇이었는지를 알게 되었습니다.
수치예요. It's a big shame. To a lady. Her job, her past job, was a harlot. She was a prostitute. Now became bride of Christ and joined the church. What was her job? Her job was a prostitute. Rahab the harlot. Wow! It wasn't deleted. You know, so many of us pray really hard. Father, I had this past shame. Please get that deleted from my life, but it's still there, staining. You're not working, you know? Have you been there?
치료 좀 해주세요. 하나님 이런 수치를 제발 제거해주세요.
But God sometimes just let that remain in there. Why? To show that if you believe in God, if you love God, and if you called, you know, you're called to according to His purpose, everything works for the good. You know what happened? There's a guy named Salmon. Okay? He was an affluent architect of Bethlehem. He built the city, Bethlehem. He was a rich guy. The rich guy heard the story of Rahab. And he was deeply impressed. And she fell in love with her. Because of her job. I love you. She came and proposed to her. Would you marry me? Affluent architect in Bethlehem named Salmon fell in love with Rahab, who made a faith decision against the culture by faith, and he made a faith decision to marry her against the culture. Because that time, marrying the prostitute is against the culture. Nobody wants to marry the prostitute.
라합이 모든 사람과 반대되는 결정을 내렸다는 그 소식을 듣고 모든 사람들과 반대되는 결정을 내리기를 원하는 Salmon, 믿음의 사람 Salmon이 레이엡에게 와서 결혼하자고 얘기합니다. Why did Anthony the architect in Bethlehem named Simon propose to her? Because her job was the harlot.
그녀가 창녀였기 때문이에요. 그리고 창녀였고 그녀가 믿음의 결정을 내렸기 때문에 그녀의 가장 큰 수치가 하나님이 축복하셔서 축복으로 변하는 것입니다. 문제는 내가 어떤 수치를 갖고 있냐가 아닙니다. 문제는 나의 인생에 어떤 결점이 있느냐가 아닙니다. 내가 그것을 하나님께 드리고 있냐는 거예요. 하나님이 그것을 축복하게 하기 위해서 내가 하나님께 드리는 믿음이 있냐는 겁니다. 하나님, 나는 꼬였습니다. Oh Lord, I am a prostitute. My life is over. She doesn't have that kind of attitude. She believed in God. That God, in God, all things works for the good. All things work for the good.
If you believe in God, and you love Him, and you're called according to His purpose, you make a faith decision. You move on. Not I move on no matter what. No matter what I went through, no matter what kind of past I have, I don't care. You can make, turn everything into blessing. And she made that decision. And his name is recorded. Her name is recorded in the Hall of Faith. Salmon. Do you know who Salmon is? Salmon. Not salmon, okay? Salmon is 연어. Salmon. You shouldn't eat salmon. Salmon. Guy named Salmon. The guy named Salmon is written in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 1. 이 살몬의 이름은 마태복음 1장에 기록되어 있습니다. 살몬은 라합에서 보아스를 낳고 보아스는 룻에서 오벳을 낳고 오벳은 이새를 낳고 이새는 다윗 왕을 낳으니라. Rahab the harlot became the grand great 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 grandmother of Jesus. You make a faith decision today, you're gonna belong to the 구속사. Okay? God's history. What is God's history? That's a human history, right? That's what humans do all the time. That's sin, smeared with sin, depravity. What is God's history? What is 구속사? 구속사 is what God is doing all the time. When you make a faith decision, you belong to, you join what God is doing in your life. You're going to experience God in your life. By making a decision, Rahab the harlot, join 구속사. By making a faith decision today, you make a faith decision today, you're going to join what God is doing in your life. You're going to see God working, not you working, but you're going to see God working. I pray that God, Holy Spirit, work to turn everything that I have and align everything that I have with Christ. God can be seen everywhere when His people make faith decisions. God cannot be hidden anymore. People can see God. That's 전도. Okay? There are two conflicts, two concepts in the Bible that seem to conflict with each other. The first is justification by faith, okay, that is recorded in Romans 3, and justification by works that is recorded in the book of James.
믿음으로 의롭게 됨과 행함으로 의롭게 됨, 이 두 가지가 상반되는 개념처럼 느껴지는 개념이 있습니다. 우리가 의롭게 됩니다. 믿음으로 의롭게 되는 거예요. 그러나 행함으로 의롭게 된다는 말이 나와요. 헷갈리는 거예요. Let me tell you this theological difference. Okay?
Justification by faith, which means what? You believe in Jesus Christ. Okay? You accept Him as your Lord and Savior. And you let His blood cover yourself. Let His hesed cover you. And you're going to go to heaven. Okay? By justification by faith, Justification by faith.
믿음으로 의롭게 됨으로 우리 모두는 천국에 갑니다.
But justification by works, by making a decision against the culture, choosing God over the popularity, over the money, over the financial issues, over the marriage, over the things that you cherish. By making those decisions, you see the heaven comes upon you.
Justification by faith, you go to go to heaven. So many people, so many Christians, they are going to heaven, that's for sure, but heaven is not in their life. Heaven doesn't come upon them by justification, by works, by obedience, by making a decision to go against the culture. You're going to see that heaven comes upon you. That's why we need to do the two kinds of repentance we already talked about, right? To go to heaven, one, you got to repent your original sin. But to see the heaven come upon you, you got to repent your personal sins. 천국을 가는 데는 나의 오리지널 원죄를 회개하면 됩니다. 그러나 천국이 나의 인생에서 보이기 위해서는 나의 자범죄를 회개하는 거예요. 내 인생에서 내가 하나님 믿음대로 살지 않는 부분들을 해결하는 겁니다. 내가 사이트로 사는 것이 아니라 믿음으로 살지 않는 부분을 분석하는 거예요. 그리고 그 길로 갑니다. Then you will see, I guarantee, like Rahab. Lots of people say, 창렬아, 라합은 창렬했잖아. 라합은 창렬했잖아. Sure, Rahab was the prostitute. But when the prostitute you think of so lowly made a faith decision, and God brought her out of there, and that the kingdom of God, the heaven, the power of supernatural power of God comes upon her, even though she was a prostitute. 창녀였던 나합의 인생이 변했다라면 우리의 인생은 얼마나 더 변할 수 있겠습니까? 하나님이 창녀였던 나합의 인생을 변할 수 있게 했더라면, 믿음의 결정을 통하여 창녀였던 나합의 인생이 변할 수 있었더라면, 그 믿음의 결정이 창녀의 나합의 인생을 구속사로 들어가여 창대하게 할 수 있었더라면, 여러분이 오늘 바로 이 순간 하나님 앞에 믿음의 결정을 내렸을 때 여러분의 인생은 얼마나 더 변할 수 있겠나요? This is the message. And this is the challenge that the Holy Spirit wants you to take and apply that into your life for next week. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for this time. Let us think about the areas. 하나님, 오늘 우리가 예수 그리스도께서 십자가에 못 박혀 죽으신 이유가 우리 인생에서 구현되지 않는 이유를 하나님이 역사하지 않으심으로 말하고 있지는 않습니까? 하나님이 우리를 버린 것이 아니라 우리가 하나님을 버린 것이 아닙니까? 하나님이 우리 인생에 역사하지 않는 것이, 예수 그리스도의 십자가에 은혜가 없는 것이 아니라 우리가 예수 그리스도의 십자가의 은혜를 소중하게 생각하지 않기 때문이 아닙니까? 주여, 우리 모두가 주께로 가게 하여 주옵소서. 하나님께 우리 인생을 마치게 하시고, Let's align ourselves with God and choose God over popularity, over anything that we cherish. Let us choose God. We pray all these things in Jesus' name.